Well, I think it's whether you're saying we find a way back to it or whether we are talking about finding a way forward to the kind of budgetary arrangements that you would have in Valencia or Kaiser Permanente. I mean, I think there is a very important need for focus on integration and basing budgetary decisions on prevention rather than cure. So we've got the 44 sustainability and transformation areas that NHS England have announced, which are precisely designed to enable that to happen. And just to be very direct, you know, things like suspending the tariff in particular areas for particular arrangements is very much on the table. And that's why we are asking areas to look at three-year budgets during the course of this year. The spending review was only announced in November, and we needed to give people some stability for 16-17. But going forward until the end of the Parliament, we absolutely need to make sure that the incentives are right in terms of the way the tariff system works, and that will, I'm sure, involve significant reform.
So you see it moving more towards population-based, place-based, network-based funding rather than this tariff mechanism?
I think it's whether you're saying we find a way back to it or whether we are talking about finding a way forward to the kind of budgetary arrangements that you would have in Valencia or Kaiser Permanente.
Kaiser Permanente is the largest HMO in the country, and Donnell Keyes was fortunate enough to be fully insured by them. It's a good thing, because one night, her 18-month-old daughter, Michelle, developed a fever of over 104. So like any responsible mom, she called 911, and the ambulance took Michelle to the closest hospital. The hospital checked with her HMO, and they were told that Kaiser would not cover the tests and the antibiotics necessary to treat Michelle. She would have to take her to an in-network, Kaiser-owned hospital.
Kaiser said that I should bring her by car to the hospital and that she shouldn't be treated at Martin Luther King. And I just continued to ask them to treat her, and they refused. My daughter got worse, and she had a seizure.
Donnell begged the doctors to not listen to Kaiser and to treat her daughter.
I was escorted out of the hospital because they felt that I was a threat.
After hours of delay, she was transported to Kaiser and got there just in time to go into cardiac arrest.
They worked on her for about 30 minutes trying to revive her. And the doctors came in and let us know that she had expired. I was in a daze, a real daze. It just didn't seem real. I just held her. I held her and I told her that Mommy tried her best to help her, to make sure that she was going to get the treatment that she needed to receive. And that I was sorry that I wasn't able to help her.
But going forward until the end of the Parliament, we absolutely need to make sure that the incentives are right in terms of the way the tariff system works, and that will, I'm sure, involve significant reform.
So you see it moving more towards population-based, place-based, network-based funding
Absolutely.
Rather than this tariff mechanism.
Dr. Linda Pino, a former medical reviewer at Humana.
My name is Linda Pino. I am here primarily today to make a public confession. In the spring of 1987, as a physician, I denied a man a necessary operation that would have saved his life and thus caused his death. No person and no group has held me accountable for this, because in fact, what I did was I saved a company $500,000 for this. And furthermore, this particular act secured my reputation as a good medical director, and it ensured my continued advancement in the healthcare field. I went from making a few hundred dollars a week as a medical reviewer to an escalating six-figure income as a physician executive. In all my work, I had one primary duty, and that was to use my medical expertise for the financial benefit of the organization for which I worked. And I was told repeatedly that I was not denying care, I was simply denying payment. I know how managed care maims and kills patients. So I'm here to tell you about the dirty work of managed care. And I'm haunted by the thousands of pieces of paper in which I have written that deadly word, denied. Thank you.
How did we get to the point of doctors at health insurance companies actually being responsible for the deaths of patients? Who invented this system? How did this all begin? Where did the HMO start? Thanks to the wonders of magnetic tape, we know.
I am proposing today a new national health strategy. The purpose of this program is simply this. I want America to have the finest health care in the world. And I want every American to be able to have that care when he needs it.
The plan hatched between Nixon and Edgar Kaiser worked. In the ensuing years, patients were given less and less care.